Living Seed Media brings to you God's Word, which is His comprehensive equipment for changing lives. May the Lord impact your heart as you encounter His Word. For further inquiry or counsel, contact Peace House, P.O. Box 971, Boko, Benue State, Nigeria. Telephone numbers 0703-036-3659, 0703-768-1198. Email address lsmedia@livingseed.org or visit our website at www.livingseed.org. Let us sit back and listen as the servant of God brings forth the word of life.
Father, this is not a mere ceremony. It is a very grave, very solemn moment to which you have brought us. For several years, you have used some of our lives as instruments in your hands to mold several of these lives, that the time has now come to invoke your grace upon their lives, invoke your presence upon them, and cause that you will send them forth, even all the more specially from this moment into your vineyard, equipped, correctly guided to serve your purpose, to be effective in your hand. It's a moment that is the climax for those from Frazet, a climax of 3 years of training, and in some other trainings, two years, but very intense. It's been a time of looking to you to reshape and to refill their vessels after you've emptied them of themselves. And we are coming to you with trembling hands, with trembling hearts. We are coming at this point, trusting that what you have begun to do, you will perfect it now. In fact, this point is the high point of all that has transpired in their training. We pray and ask, therefore, that every moment of it, you will be accomplishing your work in each and every one of their lives. As we come to this point of a brief charge, for all of the time we have is altogether very brief. But we pray that in the brevity of all of it, you will accomplish all of the desire of your heart upon your people. This is not only appropriate, relevant, and useful to those that are being commissioned. There are moments that you are using to edify us all, to exalt us all, to minister light and the wisdom of heaven to each of our hearts. It's also a moment of recruitment for those who may be yet to pass through this help in their lives. And we are praying that whatever be the kind of help you intend to bring to each one of our lives, that you will arrive at accomplishing it in its fullest to the praise of your glory. Thank you, Father, for we know you will do beyond all of our asking. For in Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. I will be taking this brief moment to remind you particularly the Millet students that have reached the point of commissioning, of the most essential issue we have raised with you in the course of your training. I would be seeking the help of the Spirit of our Father in Heaven to impress on your heart a reality, a truth that you must not miss as you are commissioned from here. The mark that must define your identity, and you would have correctly reflected what God has been planting in your lives. We will read from Ephesians chapter 4 as we seek to touch this issue in a number of its implications and its applications, and to pray that God renews your understanding in this matter much, much more before we shall be laying hands on you and laying the commission upon your lives to send you forth from the training in Millet, in Frazette, and in all the other names according to the languages of its training up to date. In Ephesians chapter 4, if you have arrived there, I intend to start from verse 4. The Bible says, and we have always emphasized, that there is one body and one spirit. Even as you are called in one hope of your calling. There is one Lord, there is one faith, there is one baptism. There is one God and Father of all, who is above all, and through all, and in you all. But to every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore he saith, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto men. Verse 11. And he gave some apostles. He gave some to operate as prophets. He gave some to be instruments as evangelists in the hand of God. Some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ, till we all come in the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. So that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive, but speaking the truth in love, may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ, from whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which every joint supplies, according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, maketh increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. Amen. We have not kept you in doubt of the focus of ministry that we should concentrate our lives on in seeking to be transformed in our own selves. The focus of ministry that should be what under God we are laboring and trusting that God will achieve in the lives of those that we touch. And again, before the commissioning, and particularly the laying on of hands to release you into all that you have received at the hands of the Lord in our midst, in Millet, we want to again remind you of what to ever pursue in life in the hand of God, and what to ever seek to achieve in serving God, outside of which we would have been only running around in circles, outside of which you will be pursuing emptiness. And this that we speak about has to do with conformity to the total person of Jesus. Conformity to his nature, conformity to his mindset, conformity to his way of life, conformity to the interests that he has decided to pursue in life, conformity to his relationship with the Father, conformity to his relationship with man, conformity to his attitude to the world, conformity to his attitude to sin, conformity to his attitude to his own personal life. We desire that you come to the understanding and that you maintain a strong attachment, first to pursue becoming like him in your personal day-to-day life, in all of your interactions, in all that you think or say or do, and that you attach yourself strongly to pursuing the training and the equipping, the transformation of every life you touch to also become in all things like Jesus. I want to particularly let you know that this is the anchor of life that God will have us to always have. And by that, we will become solid, immovable, and undefiled. It is the way of life that endures forever and that will ever please God. And is the only way of life that can experience good success. that can be fruitful in the eyes of God and that can advance his own kingdom upon the earth. If this is not what your vision is about, that you yourself must become like Jesus, and that everything you do with everybody must help that life to be more and more like him, then actually you have missed your reason for being a child of God in the first place, but even more particularly for being a servant of God. If this is not your vision for living, the reason for your existence and for all that you do, then you are a waste in the hand of God. And we have first pointed out to each one of you how that it is Christ in you that restores to you the hope of the glory that God intended man to experience in fellowship and in communion with the Almighty. And that what sin entering into the life of man damaged irreparably and caused us to be completely caught away from the glory of God. For the Bible said, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Jesus has come that by him we will not only carry the life of this glory, which is the life of Jesus in us, but that we could practically live out this life that is the shining forth of the glory of God by our character, by our attitudes, our manner of life in all that we do. And finally, we will follow Jesus out of this physical body and live in the glory of the Almighty unlimitedly forever and ever. It is Christ in you, and it is the manifestation of Christ in you that is the hope of glory. Anything else will again cut you short of the glory of God. Anything else lands you in vanity, in emptiness, in hollowness. All activity of religion, even in Christianity, that is not the life of Christ at work in your life, is a complete error and a total derailment, a total missing of what God has called us to be in him. And we have noted with you how that all the preachers of the New Testament that we read about in the Bible, all of the first apostles of Jesus, all of the prophets of the time, every evangelist, every pastor, and every teacher, they were teaching and preaching nothing but Jesus. They preached Jesus to draw people to repentance, to draw them to the kingdom of God, to bring them unto salvation, to cause that they will receive the light of the gospel and become new creatures in the hand of God. And they continue to teach Jesus so that they will learn how to allow the life they have received by conversion in Him to be manifesting itself in everything they do. It was in Colossians chapter 1 and in verse 27, beginning from 26 really, that God, through our brother Paul, said he is called to serve God like anyone else in order to reveal the word of God. And what is this word of God? Verse 26 said, even the mystery which has been hid from ages and from generations, but now is made manifest to his saints, to whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory, whom we preach. Whom we preach. We have told you that you can't be serving the purpose of God when you are merely preaching topics and not Jesus. God never intended that any of us should be a mere preacher of wonderful topics. We are called to preach a life. To preach a life by the example of who we are, mirroring that life in everything we do, and to preach the life by explaining the mystery of this life to others so that they will know themselves how to live that life having received Him. Whom we preach, warning every man that there is no alternative to this. So you either have this life or actually you are dead. You either live this life or you are simply manifesting death in you. Warning every man and teaching every man in all of the wisdom that God brings, that we may, by the grace of God, present to the Almighty every man we have opportunity to work upon, perfect in Christ Jesus, correctly formed, mature, and strong in their standing, in their resemblance of Jesus. And the brother Paul said in the last verse of this first chapter of Colossians, whereunto I also labor, striving according to his working, which worketh in me mightily. Let me zoom down to the few issues I would like you to consider as we go into the commissioning. As I again ask you to look at the Ephesians chapter 4 that we read very shortly, not long ago, you will notice that God does not intend to have many bodies of His people on earth. He's not planning to have many bodies of His children. God only seeks to build one body. One body to which all of us belong as members. God only intends for each person to operate by one spirit. And particularly in verse 5, to come under one Lord and to operate by one faith. I would like to come down quickly to note with you from verse 11 what you must never ever forget. Never forget that whatever assignment or calling or posting God gives you by which to operate in the midst of his people, whether he gives you the opportunity to be a trailblazer, opening new fields for God, the sent one, which is called the apostle, or he gives you the opportunity to be his own oracle, to speak on the part of God or on his behalf, to speak as the mouthpiece of the Almighty, which is called being a prophet. Or he calls you to announce the finished work of Christ on Calvary unto lives that have not yet been enlightened by the gospel, and to bring them to the saving knowledge of the Savior. Or he calls you to sit over lives, to help them to learn to grow in the various principles that characterize the life of Jesus, and to know how to operate correctly in all situations resembling him, which is what it means to be a pastor and to be a teacher. The Bible said we all, God first expects that as saints, we should be heading for perfection. All of this is for the perfecting of the saints. There's no saint that was supposed to be a second-hand saint or a saint of half measures. Every saint, God expects him to come to perfection. And God expects that every relationship we have with anybody in ministry should be moving the person towards this perfection. And verse 12 says, it is as people progress in perfection, and we'll soon be finding out what does this perfection mean. It is as we progress in this perfection, which I need to quickly reveal is in our being more and more conformed, resembling the person of Jesus in everything about us. That is when the work of the ministry actually can be done. That is when the saints, the body of Christ, can be built up not only by the increase of the members that are coming into it, but also built up by the quality of the life of those members that resemble Jesus. Now, finally, the Bible said our involvement in building lives must target, aim at bringing every life to the unity of the faith. Let me make bold to tell you that God expects that every believer, every child of his in Christ, should believe exactly what we have taught you. There's only one faith that God expects every believer to have. God does not recognize different kinds of faith. And that faith is to believe like Jesus and to live like Jesus. Any faith that is different from this is not recognized in heaven. For there is one faith, and God is insisting that whoever is progressing well must be perfecting his life to come to the unity of the faith. If you are a believer and your way of believing, your way of living does not resemble Jesus, does not resemble Simon Peter as we read about him, or James and John, the sons of Zebedee after the resurrection, does not resemble Paul, does not resemble Stephen, one of the seven, is not looking like a Barnabas. If you are believing differently, and of course it's the way you believe that will determine the way you will live. If you are living, pursuing different things from what their conviction pursued in life, you actually are heading on a different road from that road that took them to heaven. We must come to the unity of the faith. We must come to the experience of knowing the outworking of the life of the Son of God in each of us. We must come to the same understanding of how to live like Jesus, the unity also of the knowledge of the Son of God. It is in so being that God sees us as correctly formed human beings in Christ. Then you come to the perfect man. Look, anybody who is doing a work and is not targeting getting it right, and he does not have a model before him, how will he ever finish his work? How can somebody who is making a shirt and he has not first designed the shirt and cut it according to the design on the cloth, how can he sew the shirt? Our model, which we must become, and which anybody that God gives us opportunity to relate with, to affect the life, which is what we call ministry, we must be seeking for him also to become. That model is Jesus. And apart from him, we have seen that same model first in the lives of those who followed him closely while he still walked in the physical body that was a Jew. And we have seen it thereafter in everyone who sincerely offers himself entirely unto God to receive this life and to live it at all costs. And heaven is saying, it is when we are pursuing to be like him that we can come to perfection. That perfect man means mature man. It's like God is in the process of shaping and of growing each of us into the same image of Jesus. Just like a mango tree brings out little mango fruits, but the objective of the mango is that each of the little fruits that already has some resemblance, of course, of the mature fruit, but that they won't drop at that point. There will be fruit that will abide, and that they will grow and take the full shape of mango until they collect the full texture, the color of skin, until they collect even the full smell, until they ripen and give out the same taste as the taste of the fruit whose seed gave birth to the mango tree. God intends that the life of Christ should beget Christ in us, and that this will be obvious to everyone who observes us. But listen to me, even those who bite into us. Oftentimes you don't know and cannot confirm what type of mango you have in your hand until when you take a violent bite. No matter how you bite a mango, it will give you its normal taste. And God expects that our taste should also be like Jesus. To conclude, I would like to say that the Bible will have you as you are going forth to target only preaching Jesus, speaking the truth in love. Don't be arrogant, but be very firm and be very consistent in preaching the truth. We in all humility, but consistently. And that you may continue to grow up in Him in all things. Millet is not the be-all and end-all. It is a starter. A starter to set you in the right direction to go. We are ourselves still growing to be more like Jesus. Follow us. Grow your life day by day, seeking that whatever does not resemble Jesus will be changed in you by the help of the Spirit and with the ministry of the Word of God that He will be opening to you day by day. I want you to pray that God will help you to be a correct ambassador of millet that trained you. That when you step out of here, you will not betray the truth that you have received. You will not permit any pressure to make you to join error. We don't believe it's in the adage that says if you can't beat them, join them. Salt will always be salt, no matter what you put it in. They don't change its taste. You are the salt of the earth as you are going. The light will never dim its own shining, even if it's in the thickest darkness. Don't dim your own light. Continue to radiate the truth consistently and to keep seeking to grow, to reveal the truth of the Word of God by your personal life more and more as the days go by. Now we will pray and trust that the Lord will have helped your heart to know the key issue to hold in all of the training you receive. If it is not like Jesus, it means it is not right. Can you stand where you are and we will pray? Please, you can pray where you are. Brother Benson Igor is coming to help you so that you can pray back where you are, because we will soon be calling the millet students so that we don't mix them up. On va très bientôt appeler les étudiants de Frazette, donc il faut prier là où on est, quoi. All right? So, let me particularly insist that millet students should stand as we pray. For you, the standing is compulsory. It's not optional at all. Would you like to pray now? Can you tell God, you have invested much in my life? You've shown me how to receive Christ in me so that for me to shine your glory in all I am, in all I do, will be something to expect at every moment. And you have taught me how the new creation man is effective in the hand of God to win others, to make disciples of them, to pray the will of God down, and to minister help to every life that he touches. Help me, Lord, not to lose focus as I go. Pray in the name of Jesus. Father, we join with them to pray for our own selves as well. For you have also called us, even before we will pass through millet, this Bible was written for us all. And you are expecting that we also we should grow up into Christ in all things. That we should come to the unity of the faith. Deliver us from all kinds of definitions of faith that are saying to become like Jesus is one faith. There's another faith. So when you finish talking about becoming like Jesus, come, let's talk about something else. Deliver us from such error and from such heresy. Help us to focus on becoming the mature being that you sought to form by sending Jesus. Help our lives not only to be born in Him, but to grow up in Him in all things. So that when they smell us, they smell Jesus. I'm not talking of physically. Don't go about sniffing physically to smell Jesus, as people used to do in the early days. And when anybody bites us, even though he was being very, very wicked, may he collect the sweetness of Christ. Hallelujah. And pray, Lord, help me to grow in this life. Thank you, Heavenly Father. I will ask, Brian Ma has moved from there. Is Brian Ma still there? I want you to pray to conclude this share.
Father, we thank you and bless you. We are happy to be witnesses of what you have done. For 2 years, you have kept these brethren with us. And you have come to them at various stages in different courses, touching every aspect of their lives. These ones that are here, they started and they never stopped. Others started, they couldn't finish. But these ones, you have helped them. They have completed the training. We are grateful to you. This evening, we are here again to celebrate their commissioning, to rejoice over what you are doing. As we are going to send them forth, we are asking, O God, that wherever they go, they will be announcing the power of God, the victory of the Lord in their lives, everywhere in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we are asking that just as you have saved them, they also will go and keep bearing fruits, and the fruit shall abide in the name of Jesus Christ. Some of them, after now, we may not even see, but we are praying that wherever they may be, we will hear good news of them in the name of Jesus Christ. We are asking, O God, that none of them shall be a disgrace unto you. None of them shall frustrate the grace of God. None of them shall be a disappointment in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we are grateful. As we continue in their commissioning, we ask that the Spirit of God will also keep directing us. Thank you for hearing us. In Jesus' name we pray.
I have the privilege to present to you the Miller students, after which they will receive a charge. I will be asking the Boko Set 24 just to stand up and stand up in the presence of all of us and shout a loud hallelujah. Amen. Maybe I should ask you to sit down now as I present the Ilorin Millet Set 17 that are graduating today. May you stand on your feet and shout hallelujah. I will sit down. I ask Frazette Set 2 to stand up and shout hallelujah in French. Shout hallelujah in French. I ask you to shout in French. Praise the Lord. So it's the same thing, isn't it? Let me ask. The Hausa Millet Set 2, that is Fifita Set 2, to stand up where they are sitting and shout hallelujah in Hausa language. Amen. I ask the Tiff Millet Set 2 to stand up and shout hallelujah in Tiff language. Amen. I will ask the South African Millet Set 1 to stand up and shout hallelujah. Finally, let me ask Yoruba Millet Set 1 to stand up and shout hallelujah. So all the Millet students across all the campuses, stand up and shout hallelujah. Amen. Sit down very carefully, very attentively, and take the charge that the Lord will be bringing upon your life.
Father, we thank you for the opportunity for us to come to this point in the lives of our brothers and sisters whom you have allowed to come through this training in the various languages and in the different campuses. We thank you for the uniformity of our experience of Christ. Thank you, Father, that we have come to this point where we can release them unto your grace. And as we charge them tonight, we ask that you will charge them and you will help them to keep their charge so that they can run and run well. In Jesus Christ's name, we have prayed. Amen. When we come to this critical point in your training, at the point at which we are about to release you, it becomes very necessary and imperative for us to charge you in the name of the Lord that as we go from here, you will be going with a charge on what to do and on how to do it. So we pray that this charge will indeed become a charge upon your spirit in the name of Jesus Christ. This charge I commit unto you, brothers and sisters, according to the word of God, which has come unto you severally, that thou by them mightest war a good warfare. We charge you that by the authority of the word of God that you have encountered, which was made vivid to you while you came through all the various contacts of Millet, we charge you that as you go from here, you might war a good warfare. We charge you to hold faith and a good conscience. We charge you that you be faithful to the word of God and to be faithful to the spirit of the living God and to the very life of Jesus Christ that has come to inhabit you. I give you this charge in the sight of God, who quickens all things, and before Jesus Christ, who before Pontius Pilate witnessed a good confession, that you keep the commandment, keep the word of God without spot, that you walk in the truth that is unrebukable, and that you yourself might walk beyond reproach all the days of your life until the appearing of our Lord Jesus Christ. I charge you this evening, dear brothers and sisters, that which had been committed to your trust. Millet was a trust, and all the mysteries of the word of God that we shared with you, we shared it with passion. We shared it as the treasure that God had given us. We told you that what you will collect will be the life that Jesus Christ offers, and that what will be the certificate for your attending and coming through Millet shall be your own life. Your life is our certificate. So I charge you today that you keep that which has been committed to your trust. I charge you to avoid profane, empty talk, and vain babblings. I charge you to walk in the truth and to be committed to the truth undiluted. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ will rest upon your life and will keep you until his appearing. In the name of Jesus Christ. While you were with us, we labored to show you the word of God and to show you Christ's life. There was nothing that we know that will help you to have a fruitful walk with God and an effective ministry that we hid from you. We did not only teach generally and publicly. When it was necessary, we sat with you one-on-one in order to make your training more direct are more applicable. We even sat in smaller groups, floor groups, where we listened and we prayed and we interacted such that there will be nothing that will be hidden or clouded from your very eyes. We have kept nothing back that was profitable unto you. But we have shown you and we have taught you publicly and from person to person. We did not hide the truth that that which is born of the flesh is flesh. We spent so much time looking at the fall of man and the work of the flesh. But while we saw all of that, it pleased the Lord to reveal Jesus to us and to you particularly. Each one of you came to an experience when you saw Christ and Him crucified. Now, we charge you to walk in the truth that you have seen and that you have heard from us. We have proved this truth to be truth. We have walked in it and we have established that whosoever shall walk by it will never fail. We were confident and bold in Christ Jesus to show you this word of God, as we have not found any alternative to it. We have not shunned to declare to you all the counsel of God. We can say with all boldness, and we can say with deep gravity before the Lord, that as much as lies within us, we've done all that God will have us do to position you on the path unto eternity. Wherefore, I take you to record this day that we are pure and free from the blood of any of you. We charge you that the truth that we have known that has worked is what we have shown you. It has become your responsibility now to keep the truth, to walk in the truth, and to practice the truth. It has become your responsibility not to conceal the truth, not to hide it, not to dilute it, not to twist it, and not to thwart it. Therefore, I charge you this evening, take heed therefore to yourselves. Look very intently into your heart and watch the way you walk. Take heed to all the flock over the which the Lord, the Holy Ghost, has made you leaders, overseers, and shepherds. We charge you to feed the church of God as you go. While you are with us, nobody, as far as I know, exploited you. Nobody used any koni-koni means to rob you of your substance. We coveted no man's silver. Neither did we get attracted to any of your apparel. As far as I know, and I'm so sure, none of our leaders, teachers, and all those you related with ever collected anything from your hand or lure you to bring anything here. Millet was completely free without any charge to you. We rather took it upon ourselves to look unto God for every need that you may have throughout your stay with us. I want to repeat again, both while you go, we have been with us, and even now that we are releasing you, we have not coveted any man's silver or gold or apparel. You yourself, you can bear us witness that under God, we serve him with all our hearts, with fear and trembling. We never cried at once or at any time, begging or soliciting for any support from you. Now, brothers and sisters, as you go from us, I commend you to God. I commend you to the word of his grace, which is able to give you an inheritance and which is able to build you up, which is able to keep you among the sanctified. Keep the truth, walk in it. Keep the hope of his appearing ever alive in your heart. Wolves may come, false teachers and false preachers may come. We have shown you the truth. We have shown you what it means to walk with God. We have shown you the path that God will have you take to fulfilling your ministry. Take heed to yourself. Walk in the light that you have seen. May the grace of God that has been sufficient for us over the years, may it be sufficient for you as well. In the name of Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, while you are here, we spent time to talk to you about discipleship, and we tried to establish a discipleship relationship in order to permit and to help you to see Jesus for who he is and for you to grow in that experience. Now that we release you and send you forth in the name of the Lord, we charge you. All of us who taught you, we are disciples and we remain disciples. We told you that in discipleship, we don't graduate, because our purpose of being a disciple is to grow from degree, one degree of glory to another, until we become like him in every way. And in the exhortation you have just listened to again, we have again expressed to you that releasing you from Millet is not about releasing you from your obligation to follow Jesus until you become like him. None of us has ever boasted about anything that we have or anything that we have attained. Even though several of us are very educated, highly educated, we have never intimidated you with our degrees or certificates. We remain your brothers. We send you forth to go and do the same. Do not go to terrorize brethren. Do not go to lord yourself on anyone. You have not so learned from us. Brothers and sisters, be ye followers together of us. Mark them which walk so as you have us, for example. For many walk of whom I have told you often, and now we tell you again, even with weeping, that they are the enemies of the cross of Christ, whose end is destruction, whose God is their belly, and whose glory is in their shame, who mind earthly things. For our citizenship is in heaven, from whence also we look for the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, who shall change our vile bodies, that it may be fashioned like unto his glorious body, according to his working, whereby he is able even to subdue all things unto himself. Brothers and sisters, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, and whatsoever things are of good report, if there is any virtue, and if there be any praise, concentrate on these things. Those things which you have heard, those things that you have both learned, those things that you have received, and those things that you have seen in our lives, we charge you, go ahead and do it. And the God of peace shall be with you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. While you were here, we took all the time to train you in the art of being alone with God. Not only that, we taught as a course, we created time every day when you could be alone with God. We were deliberate because we wanted you to know that the secret of genuine anointing is in a continuous, progressive communion with God. We charge you as you go, keep your personal altar. We charge you as you go, don't let the fire on your altar die out. We charge you as you go, don't break the link with the source of life, which is the Lord Jesus Christ himself. So brother, sister, as you go from here, that which we are showing you vividly, deliberately, and consistently, we charge you to walk with it in the name of Jesus Christ. I charge you, therefore, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And the things that thou hast heard of me among many witnesses, the same, as you are going from here, the word of God came to you, it must not die with you. The word of the Lord affected you. We saw violent transformation in your lives. We saw God repairing your lives. We saw some of you, when Jesus encountered you, your families were immediately affected. Some of you, your wives came, as I want to see what changed my husband. Now we charge you that the things that you have heard from us, and you have seen, and you have touched, and you have experienced, the same commit to faithful men. Don't let the word of God die with you. Don't let this fire end with you. Don't allow this divine encounter to stop with your life. I charge you that as you go, endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Don't get entangled with civilian affairs. Part of what we showed you, we said, if and since you have been raised with Jesus Christ, because as far as this world is concerned, you are already dead. Set your affection on things above and not on things below. No man that warreth entangles himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who has chosen him to be a soldier. And if a man also strive for mastery, he is not crowned unless he strives lawfully. The husbandman that labor must first be partaker of the fruits. Consider what we have taught you, and consider what I say to you now. May the Lord give you understanding in all things, in the name of Jesus. Can I ask you now to arise, all of you? I want you to arise. But thou hast known fully our doctrine. You have known our manner of life. You've known our purpose. You've known that all these 2-3 years that you have related with us, you know our purpose is to edify, is to build up the body of Christ, and is to see Jesus Christ and him crucified, preached, and glorified among men. You have also known our manner of life. You have also known the way of our faith. Those of you from South Africa, you were there when we took a step of faith for the campus that you are using, Pakamisa. You knew that I made you to walk around the empty land and told you that God is going to build it. And in your very eyes, God has begun to do what he says. You know that we never, throughout the time you came, even though we have opportunity of collecting whatever money you brought, but we left it and will not even pass an offering plate around so that you not think we came to do that. Now, dear brother, I now charge you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ that you accept this way of life in which we have lived, and that you walk in it yourself, and that you continue down in the things which you have heard and which you have learned, and you are assured of knowing of whom thou hast learned them. All scripture is given by inspiration of God, and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works. I charge you, therefore, before God and the Lord Jesus Christ, which I judge the quick and the dead that is appearing, and his kingdom, as you go, preach the word. Throughout the time you will be with us, we never preached ourselves. We never preached our achievements. We preach him and him alone. The song we taught you, not I, but Christ, be honored, be loved, and be exalted. Not I, but Christ, be seen, be known, be heard. As you go, we charge you in the name of the Lord, preach the word. Be instant in season and out of season. Be strong to reprove, to rebuke, to exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. You also know, and we want to remind you, that the time will come when men will no longer endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust, they shall heap to themselves teachers having itching ears, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth, and shall be turned unto fables. But you, Watch your ways. Watch your conduct. Watch your pattern of ministry. Make sure the ministry that you have received in the Lord, you fulfill it. And now at this point, as we commend you to the Lord who is able to keep, and who is able to sustain, and who is able to preserve you and present you holy and unblameable in his presence, unto that same Lord who is faithful, do we commend you. May his face shine upon you. May his strong hand rest upon you. May you be fruitful. May you multiply. May the purpose of God prosper in your hand. Everywhere you go, may you see revival. The kind of things that God did in your life, may you see it repeatedly done in the life of people. As you stand anywhere, either on the pulpit or any platform God has given you, may the Lord confirm his word in your life with signs and wonders following. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. So we're going to progress right now, and we shall pray, we shall lay hands batch by batch, and the principal of Millet will come and guide the way we must go. And all the people that you have prepared to help us pray and lay hands, can you please bring them forward so that we can do this quickly and in earnest. I'd like you to begin to pray for yourself right away. When your batch has been called out, you will just come, and all the hands that have been prepared will be coming to pray with you. And as we are praying, you will be filing back, because we don't have all the time tonight. When we have done that, I will pray a prayer of invocation upon your lives in the name of Jesus Christ.
We will ask Bokos set 24 to file out the registrar, and Jonathan will help them to work out. Be quick about it.
Where are the people that will lay hands on them?
Now we are asking all the resource persons that are past Millet students and have kept the faith and have holy hands, who will come out and lay hands. Millet resource persons who are past Millet students, the Millet faculty of all campuses, and then some of our elders, our royal fathers who are past Millet students.
Please do quick. Help me arrange them.
Please help us to come out now. Sunday Oguche will join us. Please, brethren, come out now. Come out now.
Hallelujah.
And we'll show you how to do. You will stand in front of every student, because you are going to lay hand on just one person. We don't have the time for you to lay hands on more than one. Please come this way. Every man stands against the student. Please file this way. Help us to stand against a student. Help us to stand by a student. Severely, please. Because if those that are left at the back, then we will just move and take the rest. Stand by a student. You are going to lay hand on one person. And then we pray. We don't have luxury on hands again for many hands to be laid on one, more than on one person. So please quickly.
Blessed be your name, oh Lord.
Rakure, and please help them. Let us see where the resource persons end, so that after a moment of prayer, they will go again and then cover the rest. We don't have much time, much.
Now I want you to begin to pray. God is going to be imparting on you. When we finish this laying of hands, then we do general invocation, and we will be releasing unto your life the things that God is saying concerning you. So please, the brothers that are laying hands, let's make sure that as you lay hands on one, you move to the next, so that we do not miss anybody, please. We must be moving fast so that we are able, under God, to get this done.
If a hand has been laid on someone, you don't need to lay
right
another hand again.
Right, thank you. Let's pray. Father, as your servant lay hands on your children, release grace right now. Release a supernatural impartation. We ask, O God, that from now on, that which had been dormant in each one of them will be activated. They will rise and walk in newness of experience, the power of the Holy Ghost. Please go ahead, pray. Brothers, help us to pray. Sisters, help us to pray. Rima Shanda Yamakando Roboskila. Nakatao Yamakondo Roboskambara Mashir. Riba Saliha Ramasando Roboshenta Mamakondo Roboshir. Rima Makanda Rabasambo Robosh. Lord Jesus, Kimba Kondo Roboskila. Zelima Kanda Gazamba Ramashana. Lord Jesus, Kimba Kondo Roboskila. Rima Santa Yama Mama Mama. Yes, Lord Jesus. As hands have been laid, please, brothers, keep moving so that every head, there's a hand laid on you. Please keep moving. Keep trusting the Lord to release grace upon your life. Masata Yama Robo Sambara Mashi. Rima Saila Mashanta Bakao Roboskila. Thank you, Jesus. Kimba Katao Yama Kondo Roboskila. Remo Sambara Mashenta Bakaura Kabababa Kaura Masaila. Ruba Saila. Sir, please go to the next line and see those whose head have not been touched. Masata Yaba Kando Roboskila. Father, tonight, O God, Desia Ramashanda Mama 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 Kanda Ramasaila, Rokoto Robo Samba Ramashira, Rima Sata Yata Koroboskaila, Father Basaila Mashanda Bakondo Roboskila, Ramota Sankata Yamakondo Roboskila, Father, tonight, Kiriba Santa Mama Makando Roboshiri, Da Samba Ramashanda Babakondo Roboskaila. Lord Jesus. Lord Jesus. Ginda Ramasaila. Nekoko Robo. Dansa Baramashiba. Dika Ruba Saila. Rima Santa Babakanda Ramashire. If hands have been laid, please move on to someone else. Please move on to someone else. And if hands have been laid on you, can I ask you to begin to file back to your seat? We're still going to pray. But I want you to move so that file back according to your line and get back to your seat. Amen. Where hands have been laid on you already. Zemaruba Saila Mashaba. Masamba Ramashaila Makando Roboskina. Thank you, Jesus. Meswa Ramasamba Ramashira. Now please, when you get to your seat, Keep praying because we have not finished. Every desire you have of God, continue to ask God for it. Masuri Mashanda Mama Mama Mama. Keep praying until we come to the point of invocation. I want you to keep praying. Keep praying. This is a moment of divine visitation. The purpose of God must prosper with your life. Please move on, please. If there are heads that have not been touched, those of you that have prayed for someone, move and touch someone else, please. Help us to move on to pray. If your hands have been laid on you, please return to your seat. Just return quickly to your seat right away. Zema Robo Shiri. Ramatayama Kanto Robo Skiba. Zambo Robo Shiri. Has the hands not been laid here? If hands have been laid, please go back to your seat. Now, get
those that are laying hands are resource persons that have been Bile students. Not all past Bile students are invited to lay hands. If you are our MLR resource persons and you are past Bile, you are to lay hands. Not all past Bile students. So we are inviting Ilorin, yes. Hausa Millet, and Tim.
But this is a South Africa place.
There is okay. So Frazet,
this is South Africa.
Yoruba and South Africa are coming out now. Frazet, Yoruba Millet, and South Africa.
All right, brothers, let's please lay hands on the South Africans.
Release
the grace of God upon their lives.
Frazet, Yoruba, and please South Africa are coming out.
Rima Makanta Ramasanda Bakundo Roboshira. Remo Samba, Remo Shinda Mama Mama Kondo Roboskira. Please lay hands as you can. Lay hands, Kurima Shanda Mama Mama. Let nobody be there that hands have not been laid upon. The hand of God is coming upon their lives. We are sending them back to Zimbabwe. We are sending them back to Swaziland. We are sending them back to Namibia. We are sending them back to Botswana, to Malawi, the Southern Africa. Please lay hands on them. Now, the set of Frazed that are coming. Brothers, even you don't understand English, just know that hands are laid on you and there will be a miracle. Masata Yamakoro Boshi. Ruma Saila Mashanda Mama 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 Kanda Rabasai. Remo Sakara Ramo Sanda Bakondo Roboshiri. Lift up those hands to God and say, Lord, I receive what you have ordained for me. I receive that which you have set aside for my life. Hallelujah. Now, if hands have been laid on you, the South Africans, can you go back to your seat? And then from here, we are trusting the Lord. Keep praying when you get back because we have not finished. Just keep praying as you go back because we are still going to lay, you know, an invocation of the grace of God upon your life. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Those that are going back to their seats, make room for those that are just coming. Zambaraba Shaila. Oriba Sahira Basamba Ramashiri. Robo Sakanta Yama Mama Mama. Rusahira Babataya Bakondo Roboshiri. Thank you, Jesus. Deko Robosa. Father, we release the grace of God here. We release the power of the Almighty. Please make a room for those that are going back. Those that are going back. Kinda Kusa Lamashiri. Ruma Sakada, Leke Torobosa. Brothers, don't stand idle. Please get to heads that hands have not been laid. If you are helping us to lay hands, look at where hands
I've not been late. I moved there quickly, sir. Deruba Sanda. Rama Shanda Mama. If hands have not been laid on you, just lift up your right hand so that I can be sure we can see where hands are yet to be laid. Right? There's a life there that hands are yet to be laid. Please lay hands on him for us. If hands have not been laid on you, raise your hand. Brothers, please go to where you see those hands. Go to that, those hands. If hands have been laid on you, please go back to your seat and keep praying. Don't stop praying until we have brought an impartation on your life. Daruba Sandara Mashiba. Zimborobo Saila Mashanda Kabakundo Roboskila. Thank you, Jesus. If hands have not been laid on you, please raise your hand up so that somebody must come. There's a hand on there. Please, brothers, go there. Santa Karuba Shaila Baba Baba Baba. Roma Santa Yama Mama Mama Mama. Reko Shinda Kuri Kaba Saila. Thank you, Jesus. When hands have been laid on you, please go back to your seat. Just keep going back and keep praying. Keep praying. Today is a very critical day. The Lord Almighty will not send you empty-handed. He will not release you to go without a divine touch. Thank you, Father. Please arrange in a way that we can walk around in the midst of the people. Please, if you want to stand in front and lay hands on them, please do so. Give us space so that others can walk around and do what we need to do. Please go ahead, please. Go ahead, please. As you lay hands on these persons, whichever country they are coming from, the hand of God being laid on you today, you will turn to another man. You will turn to another man. Yes, please, as you are filing out, I want all the resource persons who are laying hands to look back and make sure you are touching men. Please, sir. Let's do that so that every life is affected here. Every soul is touched. Thank you. Thank you. As they are coming, please arrange them in line, please. Arrange them in line so that we can move ahead. Blessed be your name tonight. Tari Mashanda. Manta Rabasaida. Romo Shenda Mama Mama Kaura Masaida. Ruba Saida. Yentaka Robo Saida. Riba Shakanda Yaba Baba Baba. Lord, thank you, Jesus. As people come and as hands are laid, we are trusting that the Holy Ghost will flow through these hands today. Please make sure there is a line that people can flow. Rema Shakata Yamako Robuskura. Resource persons, please come over here. There are places, there are lives that we need to touch. Tarimasa Yeterebo Seara Yendarua Samoyareke. If hands have been laid on you, begin to go back and continue praying in your seat. We have not finished. We have not finished. Are all the groupings out? Rabba Shanda. Rama Sainda Rama Shinda Kurubuski. Terebu Shanda Rababa Baba Kunturubuski. Remu Sanda Yama Mama Kunturubushi. Lika Ruba Sanda. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Please, yes, stand in line. Just stand in line so the hands can be laid on you. Brothers, as they are coming in line, please go run and lay hands on them. Yes, some are speaking outside. Whatever language, just keep praying. The hand of God will
we perfect this. Please make sure that everybody who has been numbered, who has been ratified to come through this commissioning today, hands are laid on them. Resource persons, please don't stand aloof. As you see them coming, take position and help us. Take good position and assist us right away. Continue to pray. We have not finished. The commission is still on. Keep praying. Heavens will open upon your head. And the Bible says, and Jesus saw the heaven open unto him. And the Spirit of God descended upon him like a dove. And a voice from heaven said, this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. Thank you, Jesus. Kinda kariba saila mashaba. Please now, resource persons, go around and help us with those that are standing. Lay hands on one at a time. And let's see how God Almighty, who does what a man cannot do, will help us. As the hands been laid on these people, please lay hands on those whose hands have not been laid. If hands have been laid on them, can they go back? Amos, their hands have been laid, they can go back to their seat. Please let me tell all the Fifita, go back to your seat. Hallelujah. Now those that are coming, make space and come forward. Don't be crowded behind there, just come forward so that we can quickly do this. Resource persons, please make sure on every head, hands have been laid. Then when you get to your seat, I will now want you to arise. Is there any other group that have not come out yet? They are finished. All right. After these hands have been laid, I want all Miller students from whatever language and whatever campus, you are going to stand where you are. And you will put your hand, your two hands, you put your two hands on your head. Yes, place those two hands on your head while we make an invocation of the grace of God upon your life this night. Father, you have ordained in your word that by the laying of our hands, spiritual gifts, spiritual graces are imparted unto men for service. And this we have come to do this evening, that by your divine provision upon your people, open the fire of oil upon their lives. Cause it to pour from the crown of their head to the very sole of their feet. In the name of Jesus Christ, we request that you release a requisite anointing for their assignment in life in the name of Jesus Christ. We release upon them now anointing to function in the area of your purposes for their lives. In the name of Jesus Christ. God cannot bring you to a place of birth and shut your womb. As you go right now, we release every requisite grace for you to be fruitful, for you to become all that heaven wants you to be from this night forward. In the name of Jesus Christ. Father, while they were here, we showed them what ministry is. We helped them to see
that ministry is the walk with God into those paths that you have ordained. Now, Lord, I ask, let your path for their lives appear. None of them will run out of their junction. I command and demand that none of them will be a casualty. The purpose and the grace of God will be sufficient for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Every place of posting, either over a local church or over a denomination, or you place them in any professional place, we command from this moment that doors will open unto you. While they were here, we told them, we showed them the doors, the prerequisite doors of ministry, the doors of faith, the doors of utterance. Father, I ask tonight, because you are gracious and because you are God who is faithful, let the doors be open to these brothers. Let the doors be open to these sisters. Everywhere you go, doors will open to your life. You will see open doors in the name of Jesus Christ. From this evening, the mystery of the Word of God that you allowed us to share with their lives was what brought a turnaround in their experiences. And so tonight, just as you have blessed us with the spirit of revelation, you've given us grace to be able to look into scriptures and see something beyond the letter. This evening, by the authority of your grace upon our lives, and by the commissioning you gave us, that which we have received of you freely, we must give it. We release upon you right now the spirit of revelation. We release upon you, whether in Yoruba or Tiv or in Hausa, in French, in English, the spirit of revelation will come upon you. As you open scriptures, it shall open. From this time forward, you will no longer be preaching from empty memory. The Lord will give you utterance from the very Spirit. The mystery of the word, we entrust it to you also, even as the Lord has entrusted to us. We release you to go, and by your ministry, by your life, the word of the Lord will multiply. In all your congregations, the word of God will multiply. In all your nations, the word of the Lord will multiply. Anywhere you stand up to preach or teach, the word of the Lord will open. We dare concerning you from this evening. We are not releasing you as ministers of letters, for the letter kills. We are calling you forth and calling on God to make you able ministers of the new covenant, ministers of the Spirit, that from now on, through your life and through your ministry, the Church of Jesus Christ will be filled with the knowledge of the truth. Fresh revelation from God's word shall fill your pulpit everywhere you go from this afternoon, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, what can any man do without the grace of God? Paul said, I am what I am by the grace of God. I labor more than they all, but not I, but the grace of God that was with me. This evening, we release unto them a consignment of grace. Grace upon grace. Grace upon grace. A divine enablement to do what otherwise you could never have done. It shall come to you from tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Who are you, O mountain, to stand before Zerubbabel? It's not by power, it's not by might, but by my spirit, says the Lord. He said, he will come on top of you
and take the capstone, and he will say grace and grace unto it. Now every mountain before any of you, grace will subdue it. Grace will make all your difficulties easy in the name of Jesus. Father, I ask, oh God, you couldn't have sent them to us and they will leave here empty-handed. They couldn't have just come and see all that you did with us and then we go empty-handed. That which you have released on our lives, we release to them today in the name of Jesus Christ. They will walk in the grace of God. They will walk in the power and the word of your grace. Lord, one of the things you did to us that you ask us to release to them is the spirit of faith. Many of them, when they came here, they began to experience living by faith. Some said, I will go and try it in my church. Some went and did programs, and they came back, they said, this thing is working. Now, Father, because you are a faithful God, we release upon them from this evening the spirit of faith. Faith for miracles. Faith for miracles. Faith to uproot mountains. Faith to level valleys. We release upon you faith to believe the impossible. From this night, faith for resources. Since you released to us the spirit of faith, we have not seen anything impossible when you told us to do it. So as these brothers go, nothing shall be impossible to them who believe. They will walk in the power of the Holy Ghost, and the faith that you have shown us in the word of God shall continue to be their experience. Thank you, Father, for hearing our prayer. Our Father, while they were here, they saw what the body of Christ can be. They came from different denominations. They came from different tribes, different tongues. We ate together. We slept together. We sang together, that they might know that there is only one body. As you go right now, we release upon you a body to build the body of Christ. A desire to see the body of Christ united. From now on, sectional work will no longer interest you. Personal, selfish work will no longer appeal to your heart. Wherever you go, the body of Christ will be your treasure. And you will serve to build the body of Christ. And through your hand, the body of Christ will find greater unity in the name of Jesus Christ. And so, Father, thank you because you said, whatever we decree on earth, it shall be done. We decree that these ones, none of them will be a casualty. That as they go, they will multiply. They will be fruitful. We are releasing over 800 of them today. We are asking that one of them will chase 1,000. We are demanding, oh God, that everywhere they go, this fire will spread. And that through them, the burden that we have carried for years for revival will begin to find expression in their various countries, in their various situations, in their various communities, in their various denominations, in the name of Jesus Christ. Unto you, Lord, who is able to do much more than we could ever ask or think, do we commend them. Lord, they will go from strength to strength. They will grow from grace to grace. from power to power, from glory to glory. Years will only increase their strength. You will not diminish, you will increase. You will increase in your knowledge of the Savior. And by the hand of God upon your life, you will go places. You will see the kingdom of God established by your hand. And the glory of the Lord will keep you. And finally, Father, we train them to look to heaven. We train them to be men who are heavenly minded. When the trumpet will sound, none of them will be found wanting. Their seat in your presence will not be vacant. Each one of them, they will fulfill their mandates. They will walk through the path that you have set for them, and heaven shall celebrate them. Lord Jesus said, you will see the travail of your soul and you will be satisfied. I now ask that this one will walk unto the Lord, unto all pleasing, that they will approve things that are excellent, and that all through their years, whether we meet them here on earth or we don't, we will meet them in the glory. We will see them in heaven. And their testimony will be full by and by. Thank you for hearing us. Now lift those two hands and begin to say to the Lord, forth in your name I go. I will not let you down. The trust you have given me, I will keep it. I will walk in the light of the truth. And as it will please you, O God, you will cause me to multiply. As I have been impacted, I will impact others. As the word of God has reached me, I'm going to reach others. As Millet has affected my life, you will use me to affect others. This is my pledge unto you. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And let the people say, Amen. Amen.